Dear friends, welcome back! I'm very excited because today I am going to show you this tiny Arduino compatible board, the Seeeduino Xiao, which despite its small size, it is quite capable and it requires a tiny amount of power to operate. Let's start! I discovered the Xiao board on Banggood.com a few weeks ago and I decided to give it a go. It costs around $6 and you can find a link to it in the description of the video below. To be honest, the main reason I got this board is to try to program it using CircuitPython and not Arduino. It is one of the cheapest and smallest boards that can run CircuitPython and I thought it would be a good idea to test it. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use this board with Arduino though, since after my tests, I believe this board is better suited for Arduino and not CircuitPython. I will prepare another video about the Xiao board and CircuitPython in a few weeks. The board, as you can see, is tiny. It is the smallest Arduino compatible board I have ever used. It is about 2 cm long. Only if you see it next to some other popular boards, you can understand how small this board is. I have placed several popular boards next to the Xiao board and you can clearly see that the board is very small. The board is way smaller than the Arduino Pro Mini as you can see here. Great, we now have a tiny board to work with, but how fast it is? The board features a 32-bit ARM M0 core which operates at 48 MHz. It does not offer Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, but it offers 32 kilobytes of RAM memory and 256 kilobytes of flash memory. It also offers 11 GPIO pins, 11 analog pins, I2C, SPI and UART interfaces, one DAC output pin, and last but not least, a USB Type-C connector to power the board and download code to it. The board uses 3.3 volt logic levels, so be careful not to use 5 volt logic levels with it. As you can see, the board, despite its small size, it outperforms the Arduino Uno, Nano and Mini in every spec. Amazing stuff! This board is quite capable. Let's now compare this board with the ESP32 and the ESP8266 boards. As you can see, the Xiao board is not as capable as these boards. The ESP32 is a beast and it costs about the same, so why to buy the Xiao board instead? Well, to find out, keep watching. Enough with the specs, let's now use the Xiao board for the first time. We are going to use the Arduino IDE. First of all, we have to add the Seeeduino Xiao board to the Arduino IDE. From the main menu, we go to File, Preferences, and we add this URL to the Additional Boards Manager URLs. Next, we go to Tools, Board, Boards Manager, and we search for the Xiao board. We click Install, and we are almost ready. After the software package is installed, we have to select the Xiao board to use it. From the menu, we select Tools, Board, SAMD, Seeeduino Xiao. Next, we select the port we have connected the board to, and we are ready to program the board for the first time. Let's now load the Blink sketch. From the menu, we select File, Examples, Basics, Blink. After the sketch is loaded, all we have to do is to press the upload button. After a few seconds, the LED of the Xiao board will start blinking. Our first program is now running in the Xiao board. If the board you got already runs a blink sketch, try modifying the duration the LED stays on like this and try to program the board once more, just to be sure that everything is working as expected. Now that we know how to program the board, let's build something useful with it and also test to see if the Arduino libraries we often use work with this board as well. Let's add an OLED display and a DS18B20 sensor and build a simple thermometer. You can find links to all the parts I use in the description of the video below. The total cost of this project is around $12 and it won't take us more than 5 minutes to build. The display uses the I2C interface, so we only need to connect power and two wires to the I2C pins of the Xiao board. The temperature sensor only needs power and a signal wire which is connected to digital pin 10. You can find the schematic diagram of the project in a link in the description of the video. If we upload the code I have prepared to the Xiao board, it will display the temperature it reads from the sensor. We are using the Adafruit GFX library, the Adafruit SSD1306 library, and the Dallas temperature library in this project. As you can see, the libraries we use support the Xiao board and everything works as expected. As always, you can find the code of this project in a link in the description of the video. If we compare the readings of our projects to the readings of a commercial thermometer, we can see we get the same results. Cool. Before we go, I would like to talk for a minute about the power consumption of the board. I provide power to the board via a 3.3 volt power supply, and as you can see, now that the board is in sleep mode, it requires only 0.9 milliamps of current. This is so cool. If I press the button, the board wakes up, and it now requires around 12.4 milliamps of current to operate. If we remove the power LED of the board, which stays on all the time, we can further reduce the power consumption of the board. I'll try that and I will post another detailed video about the sleep mode of this board, so stay tuned. To sum up, this is an amazing board. If you don't need Wi-Fi or Bluetooth and you need low power consumption or small size or both, use this board, else you can use the ESP32. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you think it was useful, consider giving it a like. It really helps. Stay safe and I'll see you in the next video.